Root of delay. We're dealing with how do we deal with the root of delay? How do we break the cycle of delay, amen, of singleness in this generation? The first thing you have to understand is certain things that are happening in the spiritual realm. Okay, so let's go from Matthew 25 from verse 1. It says, the kingdom of heaven shall be likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now, 5 of them were wise and 5 of them were foolish. Amen. Yes. Those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. While the bridegroom was delayed. And I'm just speaking this to you because this is a parable that Jesus gave us. Now, it is a parable that you can take as a sign of the end, that the body of Christ is in a place of waiting and the bridegroom seems to be delayed. I need you to understand that there are circumstances under which the bridegroom must appear. Write that down. There are circumstances under which the bridegroom must appear. There are circumstances under which your spouse, your husband, or your wife, if you're a man, must appear. When you're dealing with supernatural marriage, the bridegroom or the spouse, the godly spouse, the divine connection is made available. The connection is made under certain circumstances. Now, some people, you know, say that God's time is the best, and it is true. But when you're dealing with the counsel of delay, you have to understand that there is a criteria that has not yet been met. If you don't understand this, then you will be frustrated and you will get angry at God. You will get angry at people. You will get angry at yourself. You may begin to rage against yourself. You may begin to look down on yourself. You may begin to doubt who you are. You may begin to think that, is there something wrong with me? How come I'm not being approached? How come all these years nothing has happened? Listen, there are circumstances that under which the bridegroom will appear. That is the number one thing. Now, it says here in verse 3, it says the